album that I'm gonna forever wish I could experience for the first time again. Cause that was the most surreal experience. Like I'm no way. What is up? How you guys doing? I hope you're doing well. I'm not so sure that I will be in a minute. Today we are listening to When Facing the Things We Turn Away From by Luke Hemmings, and I honestly hate that I'm saying that right now. Just everyone said this is a sad album, which like I love, but also like it scares me. Luke Hemmings, spare me today.
You're never gonna make it.
So here it is. I don't know a single song in this album, which could be a good or a bad thing. I don't know. Usually it's a good thing. I'm excited about it, but today I'm just like, I don't know. I just don't know what that is. We've got two videos, Starting Line and Motion, and just based on the track list, I'm kind of looking forward to A Beautiful Dream because it sounds kind of beautiful. We're gonna start with Starting Line, convenient. Oh, I see what you did there, Luke. Not him releasing this on July 9th, my least favorite day of the year. Is that Luke? Wait, this sounds really pretty already. Luke? Luke, are you okay? I guess now's a good time to pause while Luke gathers himself. This feels very dreamlike already. It's the kind of song I'm like, okay, I wanna go in my bedroom, shut off all the lights, put my headphones in, lie in my bed, stare at the ceiling, listen to this song. That's the vibes I already got from this. Oh, oh. I knew it was gonna build, but I wasn't. That was. And he's just flying. Yes. No, the way it goes up. The way it builds up. No! Okay. Do it, do it, do it! No. I just wanna scream along to it. Does anyone else? Oh my god. But I'm still gonna buy, cause it's so good. Okay! Whoa. Where did the car go? Where are we? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh my god, hold up. The way this builds into the chorus is so rude. Do it again. Oh, it can't be louder. I need it louder. Oh my god. I don't know. Listen, it was sad, but it was too much of a bop for me to be sad. I'm trying to breathe and I can't. Where are my thoughts? They're gone. We were gonna talk about... It's all gone. This is what you got out of this video. In all seriousness, lyrically, you could keep it. The thing I hate about listening to artists that are the same age as me is sometimes the songs hit too close and you're like, ooh, me too. No, this isn't a real song. That's not real. Luke Hemmings, wait, you're so baby. Did you know you were gonna do this? I feel the walls are closing, I'm running out of time. I think I missed the gun at the starting line. We have an entire album to listen to. Fuck me up, Luke Hemmings. Excuse my language. The next song, Saigon. I think that's how you pronounce that.
Saigon.
Saigon. Not Saigon, it's Saigon.
Saigon.
Saigon. Another dream? Wait, it's really vibey. Hold on though. Hold on, I didn't think the production would be this good.
What's the title of that?
Am I supposed to be having a good time? Cause I'm having a great time. This is so my music too. I listen to a lot of stuff like this. Oh, it's a whole vibey moment. Was it sad? Guys, I'm not sad yet. I'm not sad yet. Part of the problem is when everyone tells me you're gonna be really sad listening to this, I'm not because I'm expecting it. You know what I mean? What does this say? The song describes that feeling you have when you return from a vacation and have to return to your normal life. Fair enough. That one's not sad. That one's a vibe. Oh, next is Motion. I think we have a video. A video. Oh yeah. Cohesion through these three songs already. We got Red again. That's supposed to be happening, right? Whoa. Disgusts me. I notice already he's talked about time passing again. Dude, the video being pixelated stresses me out. As an editor, looking at that. Oh my god, we have magic eyes! Oh. We're not done. I mean, we're done, but we're not done. Okay. That's not weird. No. Oh my god.
All right.
Hi, Michael.
You're
going
up. Woo. Oh no. You have
arrived. I'm sorry, now is not the time. That was a fun song. I mean, it was hard for me literally to hear what he was saying. I was like trying to pay attention to the lyrics and I was like, I have no idea what you're saying, Luke Hemmings. Motion is about having a sense of distrust with the way you perceive your own thoughts and the way the world moves around you. If I'm completely honest, this was the first time in my life that I was scared and motivated enough to seek professional help with my mental health. So what I'm getting right now too, because everyone's like, oh, this is a really sad album, it's gonna be mostly sad lyrics masked by really kind of upbeat, happier sounds is kind of the vibe I'm getting. Next, we have Place in Me. Oh.
I never meant you any harm, now with my eyes wide open.
Oh yeah.
It's heaven in I meant to start a war, I was just dead wrong. Call me in the morning, yeah, I'm sorry that I let you down. I'm so apathetic, it's pathetic, but I need
that.
You now.
The production, oh my god, the production on these songs. I'm a-
Can we start over? I'll fade away.
No.
You'll always have a place in me.
The song can't be over. Shit! So they're not all gonna sound happy. So I take that back. You know who this style of music reminds me of? And this is not a bad thing, guys. It reminds me of Jeremy Zucker. I don't know who out there listens to Jeremy, but oh my god, his music is everything. And this kind of reminds me of that, which makes me so happy. Oh my god, the production. No, no, no. I don't know why the outro too just like hurt my heart so much. I'm obsessed with that one. I love that one a lot. That one is perfect. That was perfect. The production gave me like alien space vibes and I just love that. Okay. The way that I'm feeling after every one of these songs ends is that like I don't want it to end, which means it's gonna be an album I go back to. That was so beautiful. Oh, Baby Blue is next. Dude, I love his sound. It's gonna hit.
Cool, baby blue.
second. Oh my god. I love this chorus lyrically. I'm on my way to Wonderland, take off my suit and wander in for a moment or stay for a lifetime. And then he changes it to or hide for a lifetime. Okay, we'll keep going. I love it. Ah! This whole album makes me feel like I'm flying. It feels like a song just like about escape and getting away from your life. Kind of similar to the title again. I'm not on earth right now. Oh my god, there's so much I love. So much that I'm loving right now about all of this. Okay, take a deep breath in the mirror. You didn't like it when I wore high heels. November 12th. The chorus is everything to me. I don't know why. It's just like such a cool set of lyrics. First of all, just like I'm on my way to Wonderland. Just that. I just love it. And again, like this whole album, like I feel like it's just like this dreamlike flying state of perfection. And I'm literally in the clouds right now or on the moon. As always, if you want to check out the uncut version of this album reaction, it will be over on Patreon. Over on Patreon, I also have other uncut album reactions, concert reactions, documentary reactions, these shout outs. I send you guys postcards and there's a bunch of other stuff over there as well. If you want to check out Patreon and help support the channel, feel free to check out the link in the description. But if you don't, that's okay. Don't worry about it. And thank you so much to everybody who has gone over there already. Without you guys, I would not be able to do what I do, and it is because of you that I can continue to do this. So thank you guys so very much, and let's keep going. Next, we have a song called Repeat, which is what I'm gonna be doing with this album when I'm done filming this video. I gotta sync this though. I clicked on my 5 songs playlist just so I could do an audio sync, and it gave me Ghost of You. Bitch. His sound is so good. He seems so damn familiar, but I just can't place the name. He's staring in the mirror, but your face won't stay the same. How'd you get miles away? Shit. Wow, this album is so rude. So many of these songs are about like internal struggle, which I don't think I expected, but I definitely should have. But I was kind of in my head preparing myself for more like romantically depressing songs, but these are like internal struggle, like kind of stuff. Oh. You built the depth, you built the depth. I can't wait to know all the lyrics to this album. I will be in my car. Oh my god, late night drives? Oh, they would go so poorly, but in the best way. Oh, next is Mom, which like, well, we'll see how this goes. I have no good feelings. None. Gonna be a good thing. I knew we were in for a good time right now. But his voice for some reason is terrifying in the best way, right? Right? Like he's over there. I don't know if I'm okay right now. I'm so heavy, jump into my ocean. Can't you see me sinking? What is that? What is that sound? See you in everything. Wow. No, I don't know what just happened. I just didn't feel good. So I sat in the corner. That's it.
That's all you need to know.
Can we go back to starting line? Like, yeah, that was sad, but can we actually though? I want to stand on my roof. Okay, oh, Slip Away is next. You know, I bet this is gonna be a really happy one. Okay.
Falling, falling, falling in the familiar space. 'Cause I was trusting you before I even knew your name. I can't feel you slip away like I knew you would. Now I'm looking for escapes like I knew I would.
Dude, there's so much insecurity in his music. And it's so upsetting. Oh, I hate the chorus. Oh, I hate it. I'm not gonna look at it. I'm gonna look over there. Insecurity is such a huge theme in this album and also in Calm. Now I just wanna cry. No, we're not gonna cry though.
Yeah, the worst in me is racing all around your mind.
Luke. I want my blanket. No, don't make it sadder. To anymore. I simultaneously like never want this album to ever end and also like am so done with it. Why did he put all the vibey songs in the first like three? The first three were like, oh, we're having a good time. And then he said no. That's one of my favorites though. Is there an airplane? Where are you guys going? Saigon? This song shows a sentimental side of Luke thinking about his fears in a relationship and losing the person he loves. Is that not what I said the entire second half of Calm? And even the first half a little bit too was about, is that not exactly what I said? This whole album is like a constant state of fear that the person that you're with is going to leave. It was all about constant fear of being alone and losing the people you love. So now we're gonna listen to Diamonds. Diamonds has gotta be a bop, right? You better pick up right now. That's really pretty though. The bop energy's there, but the second lyric in the song is starve myself till I'm skin and bones. So much older than I ever thought I would be. Whoa, wait. Oh, no, no. Oh, I'm leaving. I don't like that lyric. I don't like this album. I give up. I'm coming back, guys. I just gotta go around the table. My camera's gonna die. Me too, honestly. You know what? Same. This instrumental is so main character energy. Guys, I don't think I'm on Earth. I literally feel like I'm floating through like another dimension. I'm not just saying that. I'm literally not just saying that. Like, I don't know if I'm okay. No, don't end. Go on forever. I just want to die to that song. I literally don't, like, want to ever do anything ever again. that isn't listening to this album. I want it to be nighttime forever so I can listen to this album in nighttime forever. I don't think this album has been good for my mental state. The instrumentals are beautiful. This album is so good, and I don't want to listen to it anymore, but I want to listen to it forever. I hate that so many of these songs are about like time passing and growing and questioning your life decisions. I didn't ask for that. Oh, what's next? Oh, My Beautiful Dream is next. I've been looking forward to this one. Fuck, to be frank, I didn't think I was gonna make it to 25. Dude, me neither. I'm gonna cry now. Luke, Hemmings, keep your thoughts, no, stop. Not a good time anymore. I don't want to be here. Take off. We're in the sky. This album takes place in the sky. You cannot tell me otherwise. You cannot tell me otherwise. You cannot. Oh. Where are we going? Whoa. I'm so done! I'm done, Luke! No. I don't know where this album's transported me, but dude, I just...
I don't even know where I am right now.
Dude, I hate that.
Why is my door open? Did I do that?
Why did that? What just happened? That instrumental is oh my god, we're in outer space and I can't do it anymore. Luke reminisces on his childhood and how fast his life is flying by. That's cool. This song comes from the word, I can't read. This song comes from the word zeno, whatever that, I don't know. Which is the feeling that as you get older, time moves quicker. I'm not upset. I'm actually having a really good time right now. Great. Anytime a song sounds like Bon Iver, you know you're fucked. How did we end up here? Oh, only you know how long you got to go. When I can't fight the bloodline, living in the sheets back home. Whoa. What? Oh, okay. The song discusses the weight of addiction and wondering if there is a way out. Is this genetic? Am I destined to be this person and struggle with these things? Or can I fight the bloodline and remember the things that help keep myself grounded? The echoiness and the emptiness of that track is like, I just... I can't listen to it again, I'm gonna start crying. Oh, I love it. Oh. Why am I in so much pain? I was having such a good time at the beginning. Why is this the theme with my five songs videos and I guess Luke? Like, I'm having a good time and then I'm just not anymore. All right, calm down. It's been a hell of a week. Have I left this bedroom yet? Oh, okay. Oh, my life. I've been beating this horse, breaking these same old wishing bones, hoping they bring me back to course. I change your heart in a silver lining down on the street. Camellia. It sounds like Cornelia. This song has a more hopeful sound, but lyrically I'm not 100% sure yet. Let it come down on me. Whoa. The depth in that is going to kill me. There's no way this is real. There's no way. That song, like, lyrically I didn't connect with it because I'm still not 100% sure what it's about, but the instrumental just hit me. Like, I don't know. The biggest thing, like, the cohesion in the production on this album, like, this is one of my favorite sounds. Like, sound like this, oh my god. I was inspired by the idea of doing the same thing over and over and expecting to get a different result and constantly living in such a negative loop of actions and emotion. Let it come down on me means allowing yourself to feel it all, the good and the bad and everything in between. I don't know what to do with myself. You know what I want to listen to right now because I hate myself?
I hope you think of me high. I hope you think of me highly when you're with someone else.
I feel like literally every single possible emotion under the sun right now. Guys, what am I supposed to say? The thing is, like, this, oh my god, it really did remind me of Sounds Good, Feels Good, and Calm in the way, only in the way, that you start out and you're like kind of bopping. You're kind of having a good time. And then all of a sudden, you're not having a good time anymore. I was kind of nervous coming in because this was one of those situations where everyone tells me, you're going to love this album. It is so incredible. It is so sad. When people tell me these kinds of things, one, my hopes like are set way too high. I get my hopes up about what the album's gonna be like and I'm usually disappointed. And also if people tell me it's gonna be sad, like then I usually like don't feel that same sadness because I'm expecting it and like there's this weird expectation that I'm gonna be sad. You know what I mean? Does that make sense to you guys? I don't know. This was incredible. This was just as good as you guys said it was. And at first I was skeptical. I was like, oh guys, it's not that sad. And then I feel like we got to like repeat. Track 6 is where things started to fall. I wanna lay in bed and listen to it. I wanna drive at night to it. It's a nighttime album, 100%. I feel like this outro is not me saying much, but all you really need to know is that I loved this album. In a few days, once I've listened to the album a few more times and I've edited this video, this is my ranking of this album. As far as favorites after first listen, we have Starting Line, Place in Me, Slip Away, Diamonds, A Beautiful Dream, oh my god, and Bloodline. Those were my what? 6 favorites, so that's half the album, but those were my 6 favorites as a first listen. I have nothing else to say. Like, I'm so speechless, and like, I'm really happy, even though that album wrecked me emotionally, like, I just, like, I loved it so, so, so much. Wow, I feel really lucky to have just experienced that album for the first time. Like, I don't know, I can't explain that, like, I can't explain it, but I just feel so lucky to experience that right now. That's an album that I'm gonna forever wish I could experience for the first time again, because that was the most surreal experience. Like, I'm so, no way. Thank you guys so much for being here, for hanging out with me, for listening to Luke Hemmings with me. Like and subscribe if you want to. If you don't, that's okay. Don't worry about it. And yeah, thanks guys. I will see you in the next one. Bye.